Hello YouTube. At Power Jack Repair today we got the Cliva PC, also known as Exotic PC P960RD right there. And it's obviously Exotic because I have done 1000+ videos here of different laptop makes and models. I never done this particular model. Done a whole bunch of Clivas, but not this model. Alrighty. Okay. Yeah, the problem supposed to be a power connector right here. I haven't checked it yet. I just figured that by the time we get the laptop, many people will already troubleshoot it to the point where I don't have to diagnose anything. I just go straight for the jack replacement because that's what we used to do here until the labor shortage happened, and now that's all that I do here. Okay, so let's see, maybe we need to take that keyboard out first. Maybe there are screws there. Let's hold it down, maybe not. Let's see, let's take a look. You know, let's see if we can just take the keyboard out first and see. Maybe nope. Okay, so I just lost my favorite tool here someplace on the table. Found it on the other side of the... We don't have stuff working here. I was thinking I paused the video, but no, I didn't. Alright, so here we got this guy like that. Like that, we take this guy off. That guy off right there. This guy we just take out like that and set it aside like that and like that. Okay, and yeah, I see the screws here, so we got 1, 2 Those are slightly bigger screws, it seems like, or it looks the same. Alright. No, the same screws all over. At least they use the same screws. Alrighty. I'm gonna close down those guys, close down this guy. And let's see if you're gonna be able to separate. I will wanna see, make sure there's no more screws left. Could be some screws under the insulation cover. Let's see if the back cover gonna come out easier like that, or it won't come out easier. Okay. There's so much dust in there. Come on, seriously? Why is it so hard to take this guy off? Ooh, that's a huge jack. I'm not sure if I've seen those around. Yeah, that's really big jack. Well, let's proceed anyway. Somebody has to fix it. Alrighty. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna disconnect the battery. And the battery is screwed in right here. And another screw right there under the SSD. Alright, so like that. Like that, and like that. That's a strange design. I got that dust in my mouth. That's... So that's the second SSD right here. This is the Wi-Fi card right here. Okay. That's a lot of screws. Somebody tried to take it apart before, because it seems like this cable was disconnected before. Like that. Okay, so this goes right here. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna find this jack anywhere. But first I need to desolder it. And then I need to go look for it. I mean, if I don't have that jack, nobody else has it either. Trust me. This place has more jacks than... probably tens of thousands of jacks, but maybe like 1,000 different jacks. No, probably 100,000 jacks overall. Let's see. Maybe even more. Over the years collected so many jacks that some of them will never be used for any model. Since the models got outdated, but there's like thousands of jacks left for one particular model, for example. Let's find another screwdriver to take this guy off. All right, just wanted to see if we're still recording. We do record still. All right. Okay, so this guy will have to be guided through right here like that. And like that. Okay. Alright, so something is still keeping it on the other side, and that something might be right underneath this cover right here. No, yeah. No, strange, no, everything is disconnected. I wonder, this cable right here, what's the deal here? I don't even see where it's connected here on the top. Strange. How do I remove? Oh, okay. So here is the... Yeah, okay. So you want to disconnect this bracket. Unnecessary bracket. Okay, you want to disconnect the cable right here. I'm gonna take this guy out right here. And now it should come up. Up. Alright. Let's reinsert it back in. Well, you know what? Here, I will just leave it here. Well, I'll leave it here for a second. And let's see. Alright, where would I find a jack like that? Well, let me desolder it first. Okay, so I need... I need thermal tape to insulate this guy right there because it keeps coming off the motherboard every time you solder. This really tiny guy right there. It always causes issues. So I need... I need this much tape. Usually Captain tape would be just fine. This is a lot more expensive tape right here. Because I just don't wanna take a chance of taking that guy off the motherboard. This guy right here on the top. Okay. And I'm out of Captain tape as well. No, I'm not out of it here. I have some left. Hopefully I have some left. Come on. Yeah, Captain tape you can buy from the link below. Usually nobody bothers if the Captain tape, just I know that if anything flies off the motherboard while I'm working on it, it's going to be a lot more time for me spent to get it fixed again. Alright, so by spending a little bit more time now, I'm ensuring that nothing gonna go sideways. Alrighty. And you would say, why are you insulating an empty spot right there? Well, the reason I'm insulating that empty spot there, so that the board wouldn't warm up here and the components on the other side won't be falling off the motherboard, okay? So that's the reason I insulate both sides, even if it doesn't have any components. All right, so let's switch to the soldering station.
Here we have the soldering station.
All right, so what we do here is we just gonna add some new solder to the old solder. It's gonna mix the old solder gonna mix with the new solder, meaning the temperature gonna drop and it doesn't wanna mix, simply because this is an unleaded base solder, which has a much higher melting temperature, and I'm trying to add the leaded base solder to it so that the overall melting temperature would drop on the connection. Alright, so that. Alrighty. Let's add some. Come on. I can see why the jack is damaged right away here. Not so much right away. You wouldn't know unless you start to desolder this guy. The rear pin basically broke. The rear leg, supportive leg, broke off. Come on. Come on. Go down right there. Come on. Come on. Okay, all that's holding it right now is this rear guy. Right, as you can see, right there is the leg, right here, which is separate from the jack for some reason. And the reason is, that's the reason why it's here, because this leg broke off in the back of the jack. And when people ask me, was the jack broken? It's not so much the jack, but the leg right here, separated from the jack. It's hard to move it out of the way. Some reason, let me see if I could just come on. Let's see if I could just move it out of the way. All right, like that. Let's
This is the desoldering wick, which you can get also from the link below, from the Amazon store. Like that. Good job. All right, so what we want to do here, this side. Good job. All right. And now we want to shut down the hot air station and shut down the soldering iron. And as you can see right here, this is the leg that's supposed to be right there in the back of the connection. This leg right here, and it breaks right there. You see, right here is where it breaks. All right, I just have to go find that new jack and I'll be back. After these messages, I'm kidding. There are no messages here. So here, let's remove all of the thermal tape and see if any components come stuck to the tape. This guy is here. This guy is still here. That's a good thing. I don't have to do any micro soldering because I insulated the area really well. Yeah, so that's a really good thing right there. Alrighty, the good news is that I found exactly... exactly the same jack. Right there. So if you need exactly the same jack, you can find it at the link below on our website, and I guess it goes the other way. So we just flip it over, we add some flux right here, right there, and right there. By the way, we do ship internationally to anywhere, maybe except India, I think, is where we don't ship, because packages to India never arrive to its destination. All right, so let's try and solder this guy up. Alrighty. Okay, let's see. Like that. Okay, good job. Okay. Doesn't want to be soldered from the top here. So what we want to do is we're going to flip it. And we're going to add some solder right here. I mean, the flux right here, right there, right there, and right there. And let's add some. All right. Okay. All righty. Okay. Looks good to me. Let's add some on this end and on that end. Right there. Good job. Let's desolder a little bit here. Okay, good job, excellent. Excellent. That's good to me. Let's clean up the area. That's good to me. The solder on the top is ideal, exactly how I like it. Let's clean up here bit better. Alrighty. Okay. Alright. Okay. Yeah, excellent. Excellent. All right. So what I want to do is I just want to do a little touch up on the rear pin. All right. Wonderful. All right. Shut down the iron. And that's the final product right there. You see, nothing moved, no other components flew off the motherboard, so everything is nice and solid. Clean up a little bit more here. All right. Good job. Excellent. Let's clean up the thermal paste from the CPU. We're gonna apply a new thermal paste in there, obviously. And let's wipe out from the GPU as well. NVIDIA chip. Good job.
Alrighty, let's continue putting it back together. It's pretty much as straightforward as taking it apart, I think. I hope. Let's move this guy here. Let's just shake some stuff off. No, nothing shakes off, so that's a good thing. All right, so here we have something like that, right? Goes in like that. This thing goes here. Oh, yeah, the cable. Yeah. What you want to do is you want to do where it says MB. Has to be facing upwards. Like that. Okay, like that. Good job. Okay. So somewhere like that, I think, right? And now we're just gonna find a whole bunch of little tiny guys here, like that. This guy like that, and like that. Okay. Anybody here? Nope. Okay. So you are going straight down like that. Okay. This guy gonna go. Okay, so here's the thing. This cable gonna go under there and it's gonna get connected on this end and that end, and then we're gonna connect this guy. It's gonna be slightly later after those messages. All right, so let's see. Do you wanna, yeah, we probably wanna connect this guy right now. Who knows if I will have a chance to connect it later on. Okay. Like that and like that. Good. Now this guy is connected like that. Right here. Like. I hope this is the right way. That's a speaker. Okay, good job here. Okay. Okay. That's probably touchpad right here. Probably because so many wires, I haven't seen so many wires unnecessary in any of the systems. Well, they're all necessary. It just, you could usually do it with much less wiring, so to speak, here. You want to put this guy right here. Okay. 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 Let's see. Probably is a good time to wipe out the thermal paste here and here. Alrighty, so we're just gonna put some thermal paste here. And some thermal paste right there. This is probably the dumbest question people ask us. Do you have thermal paste in there to put? We got tons of this tubing of. And some say, well, do you put Arctic Silver? Well, Arctic Silver is the only one you know. It's a thermal paste. It conducts, as you can see, I cleaned up this guy. And this is from the thermal paste cap. So we just gonna slowly make sure all of those pads right here are in place. Otherwise, if they're not in place, and it seems like I didn't do it correctly. And this guy gonna be out of here. Okay. So here, the way it's supposed to be, is this guy gonna be like that. This guy gonna be on the other side. On the other side. I don't want it to be in the thermal paste. I want it to be like that. Alright. Like that. Like that. And good job. All right. And this all perfectly set in place. Wonderful. Let's screw this whole thing in there. Favorite screwdriver right here. All right. First, I'm just going to put the screws on and then I'm going to screw it down all the way. Like that. Like that. That. All right, looks good. Okay. Wonderful. Let's screw down those guys here. Okay. Let's put the tape on top. All right, seems to be holding fine. Let's connect this guy. Like that. Let's connect the screw right here. You see, easy. Breezy. Beautiful. Here. Let's see. Yeah, guys, I mean, you know, there are cars like Toyota. You know, why would you buy anything else? That's the question. I mean, if you got money, why not? Probably the same reason for those types of laptops. I don't know, I when it comes to cars, I would love to have a Mercedes one day, but there's like Toyota, Mercedes, and then there is this laptop, which is really, I don't know who designs this stuff, it's just way over complicated and over-engineered piece of equipment, which not unnecessarily in over-engineered piece of equipment. Yeah, I speechless. Just why would, there are laptops that are being held together by one screw nowadays. Some of them are now just, glue everything together and just say, that's it. It's one time use kind of laptop, so to speak. Why fix them? There is one big company that glues everything together. And it's impossible to fix them. I mean, there are people fixing them. I'm just trying to not to fix them. Because it's just dealing with the hot glue or gluing, ungluing stuff. Really not something I enjoy doing at all. So let's put the wireless card in here. Alright, so wireless card goes right here. Okay. Like that. And here's the second wire, okay. Like that. And it goes like, does it go like that? Or does it go like that? It's hard to say which way it goes. Probably like that. Alright, I was hoping we would have a separate screw for this guy. Which we have to, yeah, we have it. Right there. Wait up. Don't we have to put the battery in here first? Because it seems like... Yeah. Let's put that guy right there. Let's put this guy right here. Alright, let's screw this guy. And here I wonder if this is the right screw. No, that's not the right screw. Where did I take it from? Right here. Okay. So this goes right here. Alright, looks good to me. Okay. Excellent. I hope I did screw every single one of those in properly. Okay. That's fine. Now let's connect the battery. Well, we're not gonna connect the battery just yet. I just want to make sure that we would be able to put the... All right, so you are going in right here. Okay. And the battery gonna be screwed in with this guy right here, I believe. This guy. Bigger screw right here. Another screw goes in right here. And another one going in right there. Okay. So I guess for this we need the keyboard from the other side to be in place. Or the screws from the other side go here. Okay, so we still need to put this SSD chip in there. I mean, why put two SSD chips when you could have just one big one? It's just overcomplication of things. And probably the power supply isn't the least powerful power supply there is. Okay, so Here we got this guy as well. What that thing does is beyond me. How does it do it? That's the question. All right, what, how and why is this thing here? Like maybe something like that. Like that, wow. Well, support for the screw. Is that it? Then that's the only laptop I've seen this thing utilized like that ever. In out of thousands, out of probably out of, I would say, tens of thousands of laptops I fixed in my life, this is the first time I see somebody putting a support bracket for another screw, which is not going to be here, but going to be right there. Maybe 100,000 by now. Go figure. I mean, I've been in business for 25 years, so it's kind of hard to know right now. Okay, so something fell off. Oh, yeah. So this guy fell off. Well, anyways, let me connect this guy first. So we're gonna do it like that. All right, so we're gonna put this right here. Oh, we can lift this guy up. We can connect the cable here. We can drop this guy over there. And then keep it like that. And then, okay. All right, so here there's nothing plugged in there, but here. All right, so right there, and right there. Okay, so we just have to screw down those two guys right here. Okay, so that's one, and that's second one. Okay. And those two guys right here, probably gonna be this one right there. Okay, good job. Okay, let's put this guy over. And that's the cable I have to attach right now. And it's hard to attach it, honestly. It's there's a metal bracket here. So this is gonna be a pain. Good luck attaching this thing properly, because there's a glue on top of this thing already. Ay. Okay, should I just pause it and just spend time trying to attach this thing? It's hard to know if it's attached or it's not attached. Because I can see how far the cable went in. Okay, so we can kind of I don't know, does it seem attached? Seems detached. But not 100% sure. Yeah, okay, so this cable, probably a good idea to attach it while the board is out of the computer, because I don't see a reasonable way to put this guy in there. Maybe seems like it's all the way in, but I have a hard time. It seems like it's all the way in. Well, that is what it is. Hopefully it's all the way in. Otherwise I'll need to take it apart one more time. Well, for the future I know that that cable needs to be okay. Oh, you know what? I'm probably pressing it right here and got it in there like that. Let me take a look. Yeah, well, from indication, it seems like it's all the way in. Where does that cable go? Okay, so it goes for the LAN network and maybe the camera. Maybe. Okay. So here what we're gonna do is we're gonna... All right, so, okay, I see what the problem is here. We have to connect the battery now. Okay, we have to connect the battery now because we need to put the cover on here, because the screws from under the keyboard are gonna go on top. All right, so come on. Okay, good job. Let's put the bottom cover right on top, right here. All right, we need to put one screw right here. Okay, so all right, all set. I got another screw. Another screw going in right here. And another screw going in right there. One more screw. Good job. Now let's drop this guy right on top. Okay, and now let's put in a couple of screws right through here. All right, so here's one, here's two. There's three. Here's four right here. And I think this is number five right there. Okay, so here we got this cable right there. Why do you need three cables for the keyboard? Well, because it's a lighted keyboard, obviously. So it would be much more expensive, much more complicated, more cabling. Alright guys, again, probably I'm gonna have one or two views on this video because I'm pretty sure this is not a popular model. Please leave a like, alright, subscribe. I will let you know which laptops I would buy in my future for myself if needed, which brands I would stay away from. This is just overcomplicated design right here. I honestly don't understand why anybody would want to build something like that. Cheap plastic everywhere. Too many screws, obviously. Too many cables unnecessary. Basically, this is not Toyota Corolla. This is something like, I would say, Range Rover, right? No, it's not. It's, I would say it's like something made by Tata Motors for sure. I got one extra screw for some reason. Oh yeah, right there. Right here. Alright. Something really complicated. Alright. Cliva. Exotic PC. It's exotic PC. Exactly. That's what it is. It's exotic PC. That's connected to the power outlet. Exotic PC that takes almost an hour to fix. Well, not almost. Oh, shoot. Look at this exotic PC. That's the. You see inside? You probably can't see inside right there. But this needs to go. This needs to be replaced. Because this is not something I want to shove into a brand new jack. Even though it works, yeah, it does work. Well, let me just show you that it does work, and then I have to chop this guy off and put another cord on this, because, well, you know what, let me just fix it first, because it's a brand new jack, I don't want to mess it up. The way how we fix it is straightforward. Assuming I have tips like that, I have to put the glasses on, because this is going to be sparkling right now, right there. So we just chop this guy off, we strip the wiring. Now, for now, I do it at no extra charge, assuming I have the parts, but, you know, with labor shortages, with the part shortages, the business becomes extremely kind of, how would I say, not as straightforward as it used to be. Right. So here we got the one cable. Here we got the second cable. Alright, I know for sure that the plus and the minus works. Now we just have to find another replacement tip for this. This has to be really heavy duty because this is a powerful power supply. It outputs 9 amps. Wow, 9 amps, 180 watts. Why would anybody want to have something like that? Alrighty, so where are my gloves at? I finally connected the wire like that. Well, it's not connected, soldered the wire, the pluses and the minuses. Already tested this guy, I could test it one more time. New tip right here. This is a heavy gauge tip. I don't have heavy gauge tips. Oh, strange. Let's power up the brick. Alright, I don't have the heavy gauge tips for all of the models, but for this model, I do have a heavy gauge tip. Alright. Okay, so the good news is that we got lights right here. Should there be a gap like that, or there shouldn't be a gap like that? Really, really strange. Maybe just the way how the laptop is made. Okay, so power. Exotic PC. Exotic. And we got nothing. It shows that we should be getting something, because the there is something. Is that a light? Yeah, that's a light right there. But we get nothing. Well, we don't panic yet, because everything might take time. No, this is not supposed. This should be just like exactly like it is right now. Well, I should, you know what, let me pause the video and see, maybe it's gonna power up later on. Just give me a second. All right, so we got something on the screen. CMOS message. All right, let's press, let's see if the touchpad works. Okay, let's press OK. Style Note, it's also called Style Note. Let's add another name to the company who manufactures it, Style Note, okay. And we got a charge light right there, so Style Note. Style Note. Right here, you see? Plugged in charging. And we want to sign in into the user. For some reason the touchpad was just... Okay, it does work. Alright, and let's see if we get the... Well, you know, let me remove all of the client's information. I need to see if the... If the... If the webcam gonna work or not. Photo, let's go to photo, because that cable goes to the webcam, I think. Photo apps, okay, so photo. And can I take a photo? No, I can't, selfie, maybe I should put in selfie or something. Selfie? Nope. But maybe Skype, maybe they got Skype. Okay, so let's see Skype. Because maybe Skype gonna show me myself in the... Unable to sign in or create, need help. Well... How do I see myself? Anyways, the point is the laptop works, alright? So you see right there, the video, the sound works, the Wi-Fi picks up the signal. Yeah, Wi-Fi picks up the signal. Alright guys, thanks so much. Please leave a like, subscribe. If you have exactly the same system, you could send us the motherboard. The price is at the top. If you send us the whole laptop, the price is at the top. Thanks so much, and you guys take care. Have a good day. Thanks. Bye.